problem based on the Fourier series. Okay, so example, obtain the Fourier series for fx root x square in 0 comma twice pi. So here the series is a and it is equal to twice pi. So this function of Fourier series is a given. So f of x will be a clearly given one. So in solution we will lay it. Let fx root x square in 0 say twice pi. Now, what we put the Fourier series in the interval 0 say twice pi. Now we see Fourier series in the interval like c to c plus twice pi, right? Okay. In that here we have 0 to twice pi, the value of c is 0. This is c. This is c. C plus, if you compare this interval in c plus twice pi, the value of c is 0. So this is 0 plus twice pi. The value of c is 0. If the value of c is 0, see again the series formula a n by 2 by summation n equals 1 to infinity a n cos n pi x upon l plus b n sin n pi x upon l. This was the general formula in the interval c to c plus twice l. Now here what we have to do here. Twice L, the value of C is 0, plus if C is 0, and the second thing is, if the value of twice L, C is 0, 0 plus twice L, the value of twice L is twice pi, we will convert this, twice L is actually here, twice pi, so to cancel, L is pi. So what we have to do, we have to put C 0 and L is equal to pi. We have to keep only the value of pi here. L is pi, so this is pi, this is also pi, it's pi, 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 cancel, we're getting what? A cos nx plus b n sin nx, in our vector summation it goes on to infinity. Fourier series in the interval 0 to pi square. This is about the Fourier series. Now, about the Fourier coefficients. What I'm going to discuss the Fourier coefficients from a naught, a naught having formula, 1 by m, c to c plus of twice L fx dx. This was the formula for Fourier coefficients a naught and c to c plus twice L. So we actually substituting the value of L is 1 here and the c is 0, what we getting is 1 by pi 0 to pi fx dx.
Formula in interval.
be again after plus is a minus sign. So there will be always sign plus minus, and the successive derivative of f and the successive integration of the g we have to form until we have the constant value of f. Means the constant derivative of the constant term would be 0. We will apply here. Supposing this is f, this is g, right? So first option as is, this is the first option. Integration of cos nx. Now integration double cross. Integration of cos. Integration of cos, yani integration cos x dx, which is sin x. So very simple. And integration of sin x dx is, it is minus cos x. Right, remember this thing. Now, we have been